volunteer successfully. Please, a round of applause as he comes to speak to us.
Your Excellency, the President of Ghana, Nana Akufo-Addo, the Honorable Minister of Finance, other ministers of state here present, the Governor of the Central Bank of Ghana, members of clergy, Director of ETI present here, Mr. Teimante, Board of Directors of Ecobank Ghana, past and present board members of ETI and Ecobank Ghana Limited. It will be remiss of me as an African not to also recognize the presence of Kosu traditional stool here, and the Adabraka traditional stool here as well. Thank you. Distinguished guests, fellow Ecobankers, members of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we are all delighted to welcome you to this inauguration of our new ultra-modern Ecobank Ghana building. 30 years ago, our founders had a vision to build a world-class Pan-African bank to contribute to the economic development and financial integration of Africa. At that time, it was just West Africa. And Mr. President, I need to thank you on behalf of all of us for the role that EGO has played in bringing this institution to reality. EGO Bank was born out of exchange of views and ideas among African businessmen who were determined to provide their continent with an indigenous financial institution. EGO Bank Ghana was one of the first 5 subsidiaries that opened for business within the first 3 years of the establishment of starting business in a two-story bungalow with a team of about 20 professionals, some of who are here present today, it seemed impossible to envisage that Ecobank would become the largest bank in Ghana, employing over 1,500 professionals with 67 branches across 8 regions, in Ghana in less than 3 decades. As key partners to Ghana's development agenda, we recognize that contemporary banking has assumed a new reality where unhindered access to financial services and reliability of delivery channels have become a fundamental demand from our customers. It is thus incumbent on banking institutions to constantly innovate to remain relevant in this fast-paced industry. The case for financial inclusion is in response to the need to reach a wider client base at an affordable price point. Financial inclusion is not just a question of having presence, it's having presence at the price point that our people can afford. As a result, over the last 3 years, we've embarked on a spirited drive to foster financial inclusion across Africa through our digital agenda that resulted in a major shift of our financial services delivery channel. We launched the Ecobank app, the first unified mobile application delivered by an institution for use in 33 countries. We have Ecobank Scan and Pay, which we call the QR, which is the first in Ghana. We have our Omni platform that enables our corporate clients to make payments. But Mr. President, I'm mostly proud of the QR because we were able to buy fruits in front of our head office from a woman that is selling there without electricity. It reminds me of the best way for us to deliver financial services to the grassroots. I must say that although our digitization agenda has been across 33 affiliates or countries, Ecobank Ghana has been at the forefront of this drive, delivering the highest utilization rates for most of our products. And by the way, our product is made in Ghana. This confirms the readiness because our technology center is in Ghana, so our Ecobank mobile app, wherever we go, is made in Ghana. This confirms our readiness, the readiness of the Ghanaian economy for the current wave of development driving the world. This comes as no surprise given the commitment of the Ghanaian government towards digitalization. The National Digital Address System, the paperless clearing project, the single window and court automation agenda, among other ongoing initiatives, will speedily facilitate the development agenda of Ghana. This event will be incomplete without giving due recognition to our esteemed customers who have kept faith with us over the past 3 decades. The success of EcoBank will be impossible without the trust of our customers. Indeed, this building was designed with our customers in mind. In this new building, you can be assured of better facilities for smooth operations and a befitting ambience for conducting your business with us. It is our goal to constantly prioritize your needs and to ensure that banking is convenient and easily accessible to you at all times, including in your rooms. I would like to thank His Excellency, the President of Ghana, for honoring our invitation. It's indeed a privilege to have you here, and I assure you that we'll continue to work as an institution to contribute our quota to the building of the nation, Ghana. Mr. President, I've watched you on YouTube sent to me by friends across Africa. I've watched you on YouTube that are sent to me by people of African origin across the world. I watch your YouTube when you address the governors in the United States. Although I did not vote for you, not being a Ghanaian, Mr. President, I can claim you as my president as well. Mr. President, Africa cannot advance in its development effort without a consistent and sound financial intermediation agenda. Unfortunately, sir, our march in this direction has been fraught with a lot of challenges and, I dare say, opposition from people like me, ourselves. Mr. President, we become our own enemies when we borrow from banks and don't pay back. The high non-performing loan is not only in Ghana, as I've said earlier, Mr. President, you are now our president across the continent. This high non-performing loan is a bigger issue for us, it's a painful ulcer to the financial system. Sir, we have talented people that are evenly distributed across the world. Our problem is opportunity. Our talented people, because of the huge write-offs of loans, are not able to get loans from banks. The result? These people are forced to make dangerous trips across the Mediterranean in search of greener pastures in countries where there are discipline. This is how our young virile men find themselves being sold as slaves hundreds of years after slave trade was abolished. This is how our young men die trekking across the Sahara Desert or in cold waters of the Mediterranean Sea. Mr. President, I would like you to lend your voice for the need for persons who enjoy credit facilities from banks to pay back such facilities. This will be a major step in our Africa Beyond Aid journey. It will equip our banks and financial institutions who have taken up the mantle to play our role of effective financial intermediation. Mr. President, with everything I've listened to on YouTube, I thank you and know you will do it. I would like to conclude by thanking everyone who worked hard to make this project a success. To the board, management, and staff of EcoBank Ghana, your hard work and discipline over the years have produced this great institution. And on behalf of EcoBank Group, I say thank you. I thank you to all distinguished guests who made time to join us for this commemoration today. We believe that with your continued support, we can develop an efficient, effective, and sustainable financial sector in Ghana, and I also say, Mr. President, across Africa. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Ade Ayeri, our Group Chief Executive Officer. Mr. President, the same guest.